Baumel, Miriam, Shimon, and Asnat, dear family, the Prime Minister Netanyahu, the Speaker of the Knesset, Edelstein, ministers and members of Knesset, the Chief of Staff, General Aviv Kochavi, the head of Mossad, Yossi Cohen, the former Prime Minister Barak, the Mayor of Jerusalem, Moshe Leon, the representatives of the Supreme Court, ambassadors, dear guests, defense ministers, former Chief of Staff, ladies and gentlemen. The combatants of the Sultan Yaakov battle, commanders, soldiers, the soldiers of Brigade 339, the injured of this battle, the men in captivity, comrades in arms. Zachariah, 37 years ago, just a few days before the battle where you fell, you wrote to your parents, Yona of blessed memory and Miriam, may she live a long life. And that's what you wrote. Don't worry, everything is okay, but it seems that I'm not going to come home very soon. 37 years have gone by, 37 years, but today you did come home. You came home to the earth of this country, to Jerusalem. A year ago, we marched together, Asna, your sister, and I, in the March of the Living. There on the soil of Poland, when we were walking from Holocaust to redemption, from Auschwitz to Jerusalem, Asna told me about you. Such a beautiful young man, a scholar, loved basketball, and had a sensitive soul. And you said, you dreamt to be a psychologist. You even registered and you were accepted to study psychology in the university, except then the war broke out. Look around you, Zachary. If you could see your commanders, your comrades, they're now almost 60. Some already have grandchildren, but we are burying you today, a young combatant, only 22 years old. The Sultan Jacob battle in the First Lebanon War was one of the most fierce battles that the IDF ever went through, a battle that remained an open wound in our hearts. IDF had a lot of losses, and above all, the pain for the three MIAs, Zachariah, Tzvika, and Yehuda. Today, where we are bringing you Staff Sergeant Zachariah Baumel, almost four decades after you fell in battle, is a day where the State of Israel is fulfilling our oath to our soldiers, our sons and daughters. Today, we can testify that we do everything, even the impossible, even the unbelievable, in order to fulfill our vow to bring the boys who did not come home from battle to come home. Today, we can see in faith and in humility to our soldiers, past, present, and future. We never let go, and we will not let go from this sanctified mission until all the soldiers who fell to defend the land and the country will come home. We will not rest until we bring all our sons back to our borders, among them your comrades in arms, Staff Sergeant Yehuda Katz, Staff Sergeant Zvika Feldman, who came to accompany you today and hope to accompany their sons as well. All the fallen in battle and all the MIAs, all those men whose grave is unknown, Zachariah, the family members, 10 years ago, exactly, in one of the weeks in that year, Yona Baumel of blessed memory passed on. Yona was a dear man, a symbol to courage and determination. It wasn't easy to face him. I knew Yona very well. I knew him as a minister and then as a speaker of the Knesset. I met him in all these meetings when he persisted and asked that anybody who came to Israel will meet him, any leader from the world. All of us here, we all knew Yona. In that bitter day of that battle in Sultan Yaakov, Yona could not rest even for one day. He sanctified, he dedicated his life for insistent search, didn't leave one stone unturned, any detail of information, no matter how small, that will bring to locate the MIAs. Yona was walking and meeting leaders and public figures in Israel and abroad, and he did everything for Zachariah, his youngest son of his and Miriam, may she live a long life. He taught us a lesson in devotion, dedication, the love of a father to his son. Yona had his own intelligence system. He created a huge archives. I know that before he passed away, when he's already on his deathbed, Yona said he failed. He felt disappointment. I did not complete my mission, so he said. Zachary did not come home. Yona, today, finally, we can say to you, you were not privileged, but the mission to bring Zachary back to Israel to be buried was completed. I'd like to thank the IDF, the Chief of Staff, and the intelligence units of Israel who did this holy job. A special thanks to the President of Russia, Vladimir Putin, for his commitment to this human mission and for his warm friendship to the State of Israel and to the Jewish people. Over the fresh grave of Staff Sergeant Zachary Baumel, I want to carry a prayer and a promise for all the MIAs and all the fallen dead whose grave is unknown. Let us hope they come back from enemy land. Let us hope the sons will return. May the memory of Zachary be blessed. We'll be right back.